Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here.
Getting back.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time. Thanks for joining us. This is Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction here at the HD Studios. We're taking A-Train one more time to A-Rig at Guntersville, Alabama with the Big Dog, the Man, and the Patriot. Plus, we'll have a special fish tale about a chief and a sponsor product spotlight on the technically advanced Aris rods. Be sure to surf on into our exclusive online store at fishinaffliction.com. Look for the collectible Fishin Affliction second anniversary gift set. You can check out our video archives anytime you like on YouTube. And our featured team, Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week, is coming up at the end of the show. So sit on back, relax, and enjoy the last ride on the A-Train to A-Rig at Guntersville on Fishin Affliction TV.
Good job, man.
Well, the end of last week's episode, folks, saw me catch my very first fish on the Alabama rig and teaching the big dog how to use that underwater camera.
I told you about my buddy.
Right there. How about that? Boxer?
Yeah, if you're going to put him in the box, we'll put him in the box.
Well, I'm afraid Pat's fish might eat it.
Here, we'll put him in the,
other box where Pat's fish won't eat it.
There you go. The other side should be filling.
Okay. Good job, Brother Dan.
Yeah.
And that should have put us somewhere around 17 pounds for the best five right now.
A little over 17, probably.
Awesome.
Good job.
Thanks, bro. Let me help you with your production skills. This is easy to do, isn't it?
Where are you seeing it? I got to put on my glasses to see that. I really can't see it.
See the top right in the middle. And your polarized glasses will make a glare. See it?
Yeah, now I can see it.
Well, folks, after getting the big dog all squared away with that technical filming lesson, it was time for him to see if he could catch one on that Alabama rig that would put us over 20 pounds for the day.
Oh, my gosh, big dog.
Look at that fish.
Come on, baby. Come on.
Oh, my gosh, big dog.
What a fish!
That's a solid 5-pound fish.
Look at there. Look at these healthy fish we're catching, Pat.
Jeez, he was so good.
Man, what a pig.
Got him?
Hey, that put us over 20 for the day, Bubba. I guarantee you that put us over 20. What a pig! Man, I'm having a blast. I don't care what anybody says, I'm having fun.
Oh my gosh. Let me move my sandwich.
See, I told you we were going the wrong direction. We need to come back this way.
Let's move on Dan's potatoes. He's got potato chips on the back there.
Awesome.
What a hammer. That fish hammered that bait.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely hammered it.
Nice 5-pound bass there.
Man, that fish hammered that bait.
See? I told you we needed to come back up here.
Back. 20. 2-0. 2-0.
Oh, yeah.
What's our bait? 23?
Yeah. We're definitely at 20.
I know we're definitely at 20.
That was a 2-pound call right there.
6, 7, 8, 9.
We're at 20.
Right up. Yeah, I know. I'm just thinking. Hold on. I'm seeing how close we're getting to 23. 11, 12, 13,
all right, that's 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it's, yeah, 6.
About 20 and a half.
11, 4.
20 and a half.
3. Yeah, right
okay.
There.
All right,
so what's the official weight? 20?
I figure we're about 20 and a half.
I'd say 20 and a half to 21 right now.
And another 5-pounder will put it to 22.
Well, folks, I don't know if you could follow that math equation that they did, but I do know one thing. That fish the big dog just caught was an absolute monster, no matter what kind of math you do. Folks, we'll be right back with some more fishing action there in the wilds of Guntersville. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, the first picture this week is from Mr. Brian Harland and a nice largemouth that he recently caught. And how about this picture from Mr. Stuart Miller with a Percy Priest largemouth caught on a swim bait? And how about a dandy smallmouth caught on Percy Priest by Mr. Nick Malincor? And folks, this is Miss Casey Campsey, and she's going to be sharing a fishtail with us a little bit later. But take a look at that 5-pound smallmouth caught on Dale Hollow. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to visit the picture galleries there at fishandaffliction.com. Send us your pictures, and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild, your pictures in the wild.
You know, some of the first spinnerbaits that I ever threw growing up in Michigan had painted blades on them. The new Strike King Tour Grade painted blade spinnerbaits, they have that supernatural look. I mean, when you look at the sexy shad color going through the water, it looks like a school of sexy shad.
It's not just a white blade. It's not just a chartreuse blade. It's a, you know, it's got the natural bait fish look.
When we say Tour Grade, when you pull it out of the package, it's ready to go. It's got every possible component at its very top-notch best.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
When some boaters head out on the water, they may choose not to wear a life jacket because they believe it is too big, bulky, and uncomfortable. Unfortunately, this decision costs many of those boaters their lives.
Evolving over the years, the modern life jacket is available in various styles that are sleeker, cooler, and more comfortable without the loss of buoyancy. The next time that you head out on the water, make sure that everyone on board is wearing a proper fitting, Coast Guard approved life jacket.
Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Ready Mix, serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, here's the tournament trail results for the Team Nashville Bassmasters Frostbite Tournament there on Percy Priest on February 25th, 2012. In first place with 21.05 pounds, a team of Carl and Mylon Burr. In second place, with 18.58 pounds, the team of Sam Lashley and Ashley Hayes. In third place, with 16.95 pounds, the team of John Hopkins and Mickey Beck. And in fourth place, with 16.87 pounds, Mr. Jack Nichols and Randy Lane. Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to SRM for sponsoring the tournament trail. And now back to Vision Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Clark Marine Sales in Franklin, Tennessee, offering the very best of Ranger, Triton, Sea Arc, Express, Sea Ray, Bayliner, Miranda Pontoon Boats, Centurion Towboats, Yamaha, and Mercury brands. Clark Marine has been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. So for all your boating needs, see Stuart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales.
Get him, Pat.
Right at the moment. Look at all the black spots. I've caught a lot of bass here. Good job.
water out there, you don't have to give the fish a break.
What do you think?
That'll work. A couple of pounds.
Sweet fish.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good solid fee.
Freckled.
He is speckled, isn't he?
Man, gotta love it. Mwah. Beautiful.
Gone.
Out of here.
Awesome.
Woo. All right. He hit it right at the boat. I saw him come up, so I dropped the bait and he took it.
Well, that was tricky.
And Rusty just said, I just saw one follow it.
Hi, big dog.
Ooh, there you go. Oh, that's a good fish.
Good job, Brother Dan.
Looky there.
Strike King Shadowlicious. Mustad hooks. Oh, Seagar fluorocarbon. Harris rod.
And Guntersville Lake.
And a Guntersville.
Look at that.
Beautiful largemouth. What about
that's
that?
That's a good chunk. That ought to bump us up a hair.
What do you think?
Yeah.
That pushing 3.5 maybe?
That's a yeah. Solid 3 pounds.
Yeah, that'll help.
Man.
That'll help.
Beautiful. All right.
All right, we'll put him in the box.
Just beautiful fish. Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Woo!
Did you see what happened? Did you see what happened?
What's that?
Well, that line jumped like you wouldn't believe.
Did you get a bite?
On my rod.
Y'all want a big dog?
Yeah, I'm on one. I lost one a minute ago.
Oh, there you
go. Look how pretty they are around the water.
They are pretty.
Look, he's got a whole school of shad swimming with him. Oh, look at that.
Another chunky Guntersville Lodge jaw.
What was that comment you were saying? No fish in here off the chip. What was that?
A pat.
Huh?
There's a nice little bass. You want to feed this to the others? They might be hungry by now.
I think there's a couple in there that could eat them.
Okay, back to work. Let's catch us another one. It has gotten, just where y'all know the conditions, it's got to where this fog has not lifted all day. Dan can probably show you with the camera, but the temperature's dropped down, the rain's moved off of us, and it's been like it was 7 o'clock in the morning all day long, hasn't it?
It sure has, yeah.
I mean, so it's not a normal conditions, but we've had a really pretty good productive day. We went through a dry spell, and now we're back starting to get a few bites, so you call that fishing, don't you, buddy?
That sure is, and the day's not over.
No.
All right, Pat, you just said it before I was able to get the camera rolling, but you are changing colors.
I am.
Size is going to stay the same?
Yeah, I'm going to keep the size the same, but I'm going to go ahead and change the color up. Because there's been 2 fish boated, and neither one of them were on my hook.
And that's just not the norm, is it?
No, I'm behind the power curve. I got some catching up.
What do you think we're experiencing today with the fish activity and location? Do you think that the fish are up where we're fishing? Or?
I do. I think they're shallow. I just think that they're moving right now. The water's still really cold, but the temperatures over the last couple days have been pretty warm. So that's starting to bring the surface temps up shallow, a little bit warmer. So I think some of the fish are starting to move up shallow, the better fish. And the bite has been better later in the day. Hadn't been really that good early. So I'm hoping as the day progresses that we get a little bit more activity.
Rusty, I'm giving you the opportunity to get a huge lead on me now.
Well, as Pat was taking care of his Alabama rig, the big dog decided to retie his rig, because if you break this rig off, you're breaking off around $50 worth of baits, and that can get expensive in just a couple of casts, can't it? And as you can see, tying an Alabama rig on is no easy ordeal. Now, the big dog is using a standard Palomar knot, but getting it over all those baits and not getting all tied up is the trick, folks, and you need to make sure that your line is not twisted in any form or fashion, so you need to make double sure that whatever knot you decide to tie that Alabama rig with is tied properly.
Now, after the guys made double sure that their Alabama rigs were re-tied the way they wanted them, it was time for us to make a run down lake so we could get back to re-throwing those re-tied Alabama rigs.
Hey, Rusty, what are you saying about not wanting to move?
I don't want to go nowhere, but this thing's whooping me right here. I hadn't seen this fish, but it is not.
Where is he, big dog? Where is he?
I hadn't seen him yet. I have now.
Oh, that's a good fish right here.
Oh, big dog. Oh, my.
Yeah. Really cold.
Get him, big dog. Get him. All right.
I hung myself, the fish, everything else. I thought that fish was bigger than that.
That's still a good one.
I couldn't have lost that fish if I'd have had to.
Woo!
That's a good solid fish.
Man, that's a dandy.
That's another solid fish. That ought to bump us up another about a pound and a half.
Man, that's awesome.
Man, this is... Hey, I don't care if it's cold, wet, whatever. I'm having a blast.
That is awesome, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
All right. You also can catch the big dog on Alabama rig.
Yeah, I got it.
You got it okay?
Yeah, I don't want to mess up this rain suit.
Well, folks, as the big dog's unhooking himself, let's take one more look at that dandy largemouth that he just caught. What a beautiful fish. And folks, when we come back, we're going to wrap up our trip down there to Guntersville throwing that A-rig. And we're also going to hear a story about a chief on our Fishin' Affliction fish tale. But right now, it's time to hear from the voice of Fishin' Affliction, Mr. Matthew Gillen, as he tells us about the weekly Team Fishin' Affliction special from Clark Marine.
All right, folks, here is an electronics dream boat, a 2008 Triton 20 HP bass boat with a Mercury 250 Pro XS Optimax. And listen to this, a Lowrance HDS-8 with Insight on a RAM mount, and an HDS-5 at the console. And on the bow, an HDS-7 base map and a 520C. Also features a Minn Kota Maxim Pro 80. Come and get it. Call now for special pricing or cruise on in and see Stewart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales. Paytonsville Road, exit 61 off I-65, Franklin, Tennessee. Now let's scoot upstairs to the kitchen and see what Miss Vic's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I'm going to show you my special recipe for marinade for steaks. This is a recipe that I've created and used over the years, and I think it will make your steaks turn out really good every time. And now for the ingredients. You will need steaks, garlic powder, Dale's sauce, balsamic vinegar, Worcestershire sauce, and red wine. First, sprinkle each side of your steaks with garlic powder, and make sure to get each side coated really well. Next, let's pour on a little bit of our Dale's sauce. Now let's add our balsamic vinegar. Add some Worcestershire sauce. And last, pour on your red wine. Be sure to flip the steaks a couple times so they're coated really well with all of the sauces. And then we're gonna let these marinate for at least 2 hours and up to overnight if you have that long. After marinating your steaks, take them out of the refrigerator and let them sit at room temperature for about 30 minutes. Then place them on a cookie sheet covered with aluminum foil, and we're gonna broil them for 5 to 7 minutes on each side. After these have finished broiling, sit down and enjoy these steaks with my delicious marinade. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. And be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe, as well as all of my other In the Skillets. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
I am Strike King.
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 Hey,
Hey everybody, you know it's a new license year, time to get your new hunting and fishing license, but you seniors, the folks that are turning 65 this year, you gotta make a decision. You can't get that license until you turn 65, so if that happens in the next few weeks, you might wanna wait. But if your birthday's not till August and you wanna go fishing, buy the regular license again this year and get the seniors next year. Keep that in mind as you head out and buy your new license, and I'll see you next week right here on Fishing Affliction.
Folks, on today's Fish and Affliction Product Spotlight, I want to talk to you about Aris Rods. If you go to their website, Rods by Aris, you will see a great selection of rods, folks. And of course, all of these were designed by the rod wizard himself, Mr. Ken Whiting, the most awarded figure in rod designing. Mr. Whiting knows his stuff, and he knows how to make an outstanding rod. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. And it's true, folks. And now back to Fish and Affliction. Welcome back to Fish and Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge battery charging systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lawrence Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Oh man.
Well folks, let's take a quick look back at some of those big old Guntersville largemouths that we caught throwing that Alabama rig.
Oh wow.
Come in the boat with your dad.
Oh, don't. Oh my God. That's been eating where Pat's fish was eating.
Look at the belly on that thing.
Look, he ate two of them.
Did he?
He ate two of them.
Oh my gosh.
Good job, brother Dan.
Strike King Shadalicious. Mustad Hooks. Oh, Seagar Fluorocarbon. Aris Rod.
In Guntersville Lake.
And a Guntersville beautiful largemouth. What about
that's
that?
That's a good chunk. That ought to bump us up a hair.
What do you think?
Yeah.
Get him, Pat.
Oh, nice one, Pat. Nice.
That's a good size.
I mean, you trolled, you just now got off the trolling motor. You took us all the way up, just got off the trolling motor, made your second cast, I think it was.
Yeah.
That's great.
That's your bed.
Oh my gosh, big dog. Look at that
fish.
Oh my gosh, big dog.
What a pig! That's a solid 5-pound fish. Hey, that put us over 20 for the day, Bubba. I guarantee you that put us over 20. What a pig! Man, I'm having a blast. I don't care what anybody says, I'm having fun.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's a good fish.
Oh, that's a good fish. Oh, what do you got, Pat?
I'm talking over 5. Good fish. Really good fish. Please, baby, stay buttoned. Please stay buttoned. There's a big fish right here.
Oh, wow. Pat.
That's a big fish. Come here. Come here, baby. Come here, come here. Come here, come here.
Oh! Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo!
Well, folks, there's no doubt that that Alabama rig can sure catch some fish, and these two bald eagles are ready to see what's in our live wells to be released.
All right, guys, here's the fish we caught today, or here's 6 of our good ones we caught today on Guntersville. One heck of a day, wasn't it, buddy?
Oh, what a day.
I mean, what a heck of a day. But look at these big largemouth. Look at the guts on these things. Spin them around a little bit where they can see the
belly. Oh, my.
I mean, these are fat, healthy Guntersville fish.
Well, folks, what a great day on the water with the Big Dawg and Affliction Pro Staffer Pat Anderson taking that A train to the A rig down there in Guntersville, Alabama. And we sure hope that you've enjoyed these shows. And folks, right now it's time to sit back and enjoy a fish tale about a chief. Folks, it's time for a Fish and Affliction fish tale. Well, folks, this fish tale is sent to us by Team Campsie, and the first part of the fish tale is from Mr. Ken Campsie, and he writes, "This picture is of the greatest fisherman and example a young man could have. It is my father, Gene Campsie. He and I were fishing on Percy Priest below the Weekly Road Bridge when I took this picture. He passed away in July of 2010. He and I were fishing partners my entire life. He shared his time and skill with anyone and everyone I invited into the boat. Interesting story. The last time I had him on the water in March of 2010, we were crappie fishing behind Hong Kong Island on Priest. A bald eagle flew over. It was his favorite bird. He always said the eagle was the ultimate fisherman. After he passed, the first time my brother, my two sons, and I went fishing, we were in that same spot and the eagle flew over us. Nothing more than coincidence, I'm sure. He passed along a love of the outdoors to his children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. And folks, this part of the fish tale is sent to us by his son, Mr. Ken Campsie. And folks, the rest of the fish tale is sent to us by his granddaughter, Casey Campsie, and she writes, Chief is what all the grandkids called him. He was not only one of the greatest fishermen I knew, he also was one of the greatest men I have ever known. Not only did he teach us everything he knew about fishing, he taught us everything he knew about life. I wouldn't be who I am today without the time I spent with him and my father out on that water. The real pleasure of going fishing with my chief was the time I got to spend with him and all the stories and lessons I learned. As my dad told you, Chief passed away July 2010. That was the greatest loss I've ever known. It still hurts every day he's gone, but that sadness is quickly washed away by all the great memories we made out on the water. And that's written by Miss Casey Campsie, the granddaughter of the chief, Gene Campsie. And folks, we'd like to thank Team Campsie for sharing their fish tale with all of us here at Fish and Affliction so we could share it with you. And folks, be sure to leave us your fish tale there at our Fish and Affliction Facebook page, and don't forget to include a picture. And folks, you can send that story and picture to us at fishtales@fishandaffliction.com, and maybe you'll see your story as one of our featured fish tales here on Fish and Affliction. And folks, don't forget to pick up your collectible 2-year anniversary Fish and Affliction gift package from our online store there at fishandaffliction.com. An embroidered Fish and Affliction sunshield hat that has a sun protection factor of 45, has that extra long brim for those hot summer days, and the Fish and Affliction brand eyeglass retainer that'll keep these Strike King sunglasses on your head at high speeds or for an enjoyable day of fishing. So get on over to our website, fishandaffliction.com, to the online store to pick up your collectible 2-year anniversary Fish and Affliction gift package.
What an absolute monster.
And folks, on next week's episode of Fish and Affliction TV, we're going to join the Big Dawg and Affliction Pro Staffer Mickey Beck doing a little fishing on a mystery lake. Now, this lake does not allow gasoline motors. It's an electric motor lake only. And folks, you're not going to believe the fun and the great fishing that they experience on next week's show. So tune into Fish and Affliction TV next week, and you'll see.
I got part of my frame on there.
This week's Team Fish and Affliction featured Facebook friend is Sean Spicer. And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fish and Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishandaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fish and Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dawg got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
People don't know, but these things will talk to you.
I love Fishin' Affliction. Yes, I do.
And he's saying,
don't throw them Strike King baits around me no more.